do we fix it? Well, let's first of all say, what do we fix it with? Well, the gold standard, or one of the choices that you have, is using a piece of this patellar tendon with a little piece of bone on this end and a little piece of bone on this end. So if we take the kneecap and look at the front view once again, it looks something like this. And then we have the kneecap tendon that looks something like this. And this little bump of bone that it attaches to, that would look something like this. What we would use to replace this anterior cruciate ligament would be the middle portion of this patellar tendon, with a little piece of bone on this end and a little piece of bone on this end. So if we take that piece out, it looks something like this: bone, tendon, bone. The bone allows us to drill a little hole through it on each end and pass a little suture through it, so we have something to control it with. This being side A and this being side B. Well, we now have our ACL graft. Well, let's look once again at the front view of the knee. Again, our thigh bone and top of our leg bone. And now, arthroscopically, we have removed that torn anterior cruciate ligament to replace it with this ACL graft. The next step is to drill some tunnels arthroscopically from the outside of this bone, the leg bone, and surfacing in the joint here, and then a second tunnel part of the way through the bone on the femur or thigh bone here. The idea is to place these tunnels exactly where God originally attached the tendon for the best result. So then we can bring our graft in arthroscopically, and it'll end up something like this. Graft, piece of bone in this tunnel, piece of bone in that tunnel. A, B. How do we firmly attach the graft in those tunnels? First of all, let's take this tunnel and magnify it, and it looks something like this. We have the bone. This is where we drilled the tunnel, and bone. And our graft, that is the bone part of the graft that we placed in the tunnel. This is A. We then take a specially designed screw and wedge it up into this area between the bone and the graft. So here's the head of the screw, here's the shaft of the screw, here are the threads of the screw. This prevents our graft from pulling out. And indeed, we call this an interference. Interference screw. Down here on the leg bone, we also have to attach our graft. And how do we do that? Well, again, here's our tunnel, and here's the graft poking its way a little bit outside the tunnel. Just outside the tunnel, in the bone, we place a different type of screw. Here's the shaft, here are the threads, here's the head, and we leave it just a little bit proud. Then we take the stitches that we have kept through this little bony graft, and we pull and tie it around that screw, just like tying the reins of your horse around the post. I call this a post screw. Now, some surgeons prefer, even on this tunnel, to use an interference screw. In either case, we now have firm fixation of our graft in the tunnels, and we can start moving the patient's knee immediately.